Ford and Google just signed a really big deal. 6-year deal for in-car connectivity and cloud services. I think this is a big deal. Actually, their stocks, speaking of stocks, shot up because of this announcement. They're like, you know what? And it's a thing that I've been talking about. I feel like we've been talking about. They're like, you know what? Why are we bothering? That's when the announcement took place right there. You can see. On the 1 day. Yeah, look at the 1 day. It's easier right there. Right there. Boom. There you go. Right around 11 o'clock. Announcement takes place. Car manufacturers should have done this a long time ago. Just forget about doing your own dash software. Forget about your own assistant and voice activation and maps. Forget about it. Everyone's looking at their phones. People have a big screen on their car and then they have a mount with their phone right beside it.
Uh-huh.
Because the phone is still better. It has, it's more sophisticated. It's faster. The voice assistant is better. Maps is typically more dynamic and updated with points of interest and obviously traffic-related apps that
it's
cars don't do as well.
Tied to who you are as well.
Correct.
It's more personalized.
All your addresses and everything is
songs,
in there.
Podcasts.
I mean, mainly for me, it's about voice assistant. Mainly for me. I find it to be so goofy that I have this voice assistant in my car and Google Assistant on my phone. And it's like, and they're both connected through, let's say, Android Auto or Bluetooth. And I have competing voice assistants. And we all know which one is the better voice assistant. Yeah. Anyway, Ford did the thing that should have happened a long time ago. And they're doing it. They're committing to it in a big way. The deal is said to be worth hundreds of millions of dollars. They're going to partner with Google, so all of their in-car systems are Google. That's it. By 2023, that's it. Hmm. It's not any funky sync type stuff. I've had Ford vehicles, so I know what they're working with. It's just straight up Google. It's Android in the car. It's all the things I've ever wanted. You don't need to plug in anything because all your stuff is right there. It's a bigger smartphone on wheels. And I can't wait to natively use Assistant in vehicles everywhere. It's actually one area where I was like, you know, as far as Tesla's concerned, they've kind of wanted to build their own thing, but it's tough to compete with Google on stuff like this. And that's where I'm thinking, damn, you picture this some futuristic electric vehicle where Ford can figure out the actual physical vehicle. But then companies like Google can do the smart side of it. Because, mm-hmm. you know, they've been working on self-driving stuff as well. This doesn't reference anything there. But all of a sudden you can see some interesting things happen for the traditional automakers through partnerships instead of needing to rewrite the whole thing. Mm-hmm. So I find this to be quite exciting. Everything will be assisted on by Google, from in-car infotainment systems and remote to over-the-air updates and also artificial intelligence. So, Google X Ford happening 2023.